Hello everyone, my name is Coxie. I stream on Twitch to design and art. And also, I have a small store with badges, panels and overlays. Thinking about improving your video or sound quality? Ready to upgrade your internet plan for your stream? Put this question aside for a few minutes. In this video, I'm going to tell you everything you need to know about internet speed for streaming. The minimum upload speed needed for live streaming is 1.6 Mbps for the lowest HD resolution and at 30 fps. For high resolution HD streams, you will need a minimum of 3-3.5 Mbps. Twitch and other live streaming platforms are still relatively new with growing audiences. While the platforms continue to improve, there are still many variances between them. A key example of this is that Twitch this includes the maximum quality possible as well as the activity of their server. While certain elements may eventually become standard, for now it is up to the broadcaster to figure out how to produce a quality show. With so much competition for live stream viewers, it is important to have a good content and technical proficiency when it comes to your visual and audio. Viewers won't stick around for a video that is out of sync, has low resolution, or frequently skips or loses connection. Ensuring that you have quality internet is important. Minimum upload speeds for Twitch. According to Twitch, for both NVNC and X264, it is recommended that you are able to upload at 6 megabits per second for high quality. When you want to live stream faster content such as FPS games, you should either lower the definition a bit or opt for faster upload speed between 9-13 Mbps. Anything more than 10 Mbps is generally unnecessary for home use. If you are in doubt about how much bandwidth you will need from your internet plan, you can use Cho Bryant's calculator. With it, you can test several variables and see which adjustments you will need to make in order for you to upload a smooth stream. How to check your internet support speeds for streaming? The first thing you need to do when looking into your internet speed is to take a speed test. You can easily do this at speedtest.net. This test typically takes less than 30 seconds and tests your PNG, download speed, and upload speed. If you are experiencing internet problems, it will give you some suggestions as to why. Figuring out your upload speed will tell you how high of video resolution you can upload while you broadcast. If the quality is low, you will want to troubleshoot possible issues or upgrade your internet plan. Alternately, you can test your bandwidth for Twitch using a Twitch test. This program will test your speed specifically for the Twitch platform to ensure that you have the bandwidth you need for success. The amount of bandwidth required to stream will depend on a number of factors. Those include your content, the number of connections you make, and external activity. You may need to upgrade beyond the absolute minimum to ensure that your viewers receive a quality viewing experience. At a minimum, you are uploading a video of you and your audio. Every addition to your stream will up the amount of bandwidth you need to ensure a clear and stable stream. This includes additional angles, or a padcam, high graphics in the video game, and other internet users in your home. It is therefore a good idea to aim for higher internet speed. Twitch streaming with Starlink. There has been a lot of excitement around Starlink, the new internet service from SpaceX. Those who have been able to participate in the beta have had internet speed fast enough to live stream on Twitch, YouTube, or Facebook gaming. Even people in remote places will be able to stream with zero or low latency soon enough. Fiber optic internet is better suited for online gamers, streamers, and people who use a lot of devices at once. If nothing else seems to work for you, see if fiber optic internet is available in your area. It could be well worth the investment. How to improve your internet speed for Twitch? Make sure that no unnecessary applications are open on your devices connected to the internet. Ask another household members to not use the internet while you are broadcasting, or get a separate plan specifically for your stream. Your internet isn't the only thing that affects the quality of your stream. You should also ensure that your hardware is up to the job. Thank you for watching. If you have any question, leave them in the comment. On my channel, you can find more videos on streaming topics and a link to my small design store for streamers in the description below. And I will see you in the next video. Bye!